Hey, my name is Eduard Stunga, founder of Videoplasty. And in this video, I want to show you the easiest screen recording software available for both Mac and Windows. It's called the Movavi Screen Recorder. And if you want to try it out, make sure to check out the free version available on their website. Of course, being free, it has certain limitations. So if you decide to purchase the full version, which I highly recommend that you do, make sure to use the discount code available in the description to get 20% off. What I love about the Movavi software in general is that they have software that is super user-friendly, super easy to use. They get straight to the point. So their software ecosystem in terms of video is hard to beat, really. I mean, they also have a video converter available and different video editing software. One is a bit more entry level, and the other one is a little bit more advanced. And the cool thing about all of their software is that all of it is super affordable. So not only is it very easy to use, it's also super affordable to purchase. So without further ado, let's have a quick look at the Movavi Screen Recorder. So actually, one of the first features that I want to show you is the photo capture functionality. So whenever you have the software open, it's going to have a sort of widget here on the side, and you can move it around depending on where you want it to be. Personally, I like it here on the left. So the first feature that I'm going to show you is the screenshot. So just capturing a screenshot of your screen. And this in itself is not that amazing, because obviously, you know, there's other ways to capture screenshots. But the twist that Movavi added to the screenshot process is what I actually love so much about it. So when you select this, obviously it gives you an option to select the area that you want to use a screenshot for. So if you just click here, it's going to take a screenshot of the full screen. But maybe, for example, I want to take a screenshot of just my Safari windows like this. And as you can see, it selects it super easily. Or if I want to do a smaller selection, just click anywhere on the screen and do a selection yourself. So what's super cool is that you can actually add annotations live directly here on this window. So for example, if you want to drag someone's attention to the button, you can do so here. Obviously, you can change the color to something that stands out a little bit more. You can, of course, add some sort of text as well. So if you're working with a client, for example, and or, you know, some freelancers or a team in general, it's always super useful to just share screenshots and be able to highlight certain parts of the screenshot. And you can also use this tool right here, for example, the highlighter, talking about highlighting. Maybe you want to highlight the headline and say, hey, I don't really like this headline right here. Let's change it to something else, right? So those are some of the things that you can do while you're taking the screenshot. And when you're done with all the comments and all the annotation and all that kind of stuff, what you can do is you can share directly from the screen. Either you can get a link or send to WhatsApp, Telegram, email, Google Drive. But what I personally like to do is I just save the image by using this button. And it's going to save it in the Movavi folder that is set by default here. All right, next I want to show you how you can do a screen capture video and record your screen. And you can do this for multiple reasons. Whether you're recording some sort of tutorial for software, or maybe you're just doing a sort of online class, or just you want to record a webinar that you're doing. It doesn't matter. There's so many reasons why you want to record your screens. I just want to point out one thing though. You can use the Movavi screen recording to record a lot of things, but it's not really suitable if you want to record your screen while playing a video game. So for video games, there's other software out there more specialized for that. But Movavi is perfect for webinars, classes, tutorials, all sorts of other things that are not related to gaming. So same as with the screenshots, you just go here on the left on the two icons. So instead of clicking screenshot, you just click screen recording. And same process as before, you can either click here to select like the full screen of your computer, or if you want to select the window that already exists, either the Safari window with the browser included, with the address bar included, sorry, or without it like this. So I'll just go with this selection. And here you have a couple more settings, right? So for example, you can turn the webcam on and off, and it's gonna show up in the corner depending on where you place it in the settings. I'll cover that a bit later in this video. And of course, you can turn the microphone on and off, system audio on and off, and a couple of other super cool things here on the right. If you want to record your keystrokes so the users can follow the buttons that you're pressing on a keyboard, this is really useful to have. And if you want to highlight your cursor like this so it's easier to follow, I mean, you're not going to be able to see it now, you'll see it after. Or this one, you can turn it on as well to highlight the mouse clicks, right? So users, again, can find it super easy to follow exactly what you're doing. So when it's all said and done and you're ready to record, just click this button right here, and it's going to start recording any minute. So after this countdown, it's basically going to start recording. And as you can see here, it also shows you how much time has passed. So yeah. All right, let's assume we're done with the recording. Now I'll just press the stop button right here. And now it's gonna bring us to this sort of post-production panel where you can just quickly do a bit of editing on your screen recording. You can do super basic stuff like cutting parts of it out, right? So you can either play it back using this button, of course. You can see here on the bottom, I mean, the webcam wasn't, the angle wasn't the best, but hey, it's there. I mean, you can adjust it and play around with it. But for example, let's say you want to cut it, right? So use this button right here, and it's going to allow you to select a fragment of the video, and you can just pull it from those sides at the end. And let's say, I don't know, you just don't want this part of the end completely. And that's where you just click this button right here to delete the fragment, and it's gone. So when you're done doing your basic trimming and you want to export the video, you can either share it using some of those buttons so you can get a link, share it on WhatsApp, Telegram. You can even share it directly on YouTube or Google Drive. But personally, I prefer to export the video. So what I suggest you do as well is you click this button right here that says export. And here it's going to ask you a couple of basic settings, right? So you obviously want to give it a file name. And you also need to give it a location on your computer where you want to save it. In terms of format, unless you know what you're doing, I suggest you stick with MP4. It's probably the easiest and most widely available format out there. And you also want to make sure you have Super Speed On, which is a technology from Movavi that's going to make sure the exporting process won't take that long. Another really cool thing that you can do using this software, and I don't recommend you do it for long videos, only for short 5, maybe 10 second parts of the video, is you can export it as a GIF if it's something funny that happened or you want to make a meme out of it or something like that. But keep in mind, if you export it as a GIF, there's not going to be any audio because this is basically an image format. So it's only going to be the visual part, right? So when it's all said and done, just click save, and it's going to take a little bit to transcode the video or the GIF, whatever you're doing. And when it's done, the video or the GIF is going to be available in the default location. So let's fast forward to that. All right, so now if I just click show in folder, it's going to open the folder. And as we can see, we have the GIF available here, which is pretty large. So I don't suggest you do this quite often unless it's a very short segment of your video. So let's open the GIF and see how it looks. Actually, I'm pretty impressed with the quality considering this is a massive screen recording actually. And what I was saying earlier about highlighting your cursor, you can actually see it here. There's a bit of a like blue shadow around it, which makes it much easier to follow around. All right, the last thing that I want to show you in the software is some of the settings that you might find very useful. Right, so I'm going to skip over the general ones. They're going to be super simple to understand. But what's super useful is to know some of the keyboard shortcuts, for example, to start or to stop the capture, or even to just take a screenshot. It's actually incredibly helpful to know those. Also for video, I suggest you leave everything as it is by default, even the frame rate. I can't honestly imagine a time where you will need 60 frames per second, so definitely leave this as it is. And also you want to make sure you have this enabled, the super speed conversion, to make sure your exporting speeds are going to be super fast. For the webcam, obviously you want to make sure it's working. You can also set the resolution to something higher if you prefer that. Again, leave it at 30 frames per second. But this is where you can actually move it around. Maybe you want it on the lower left corner, upper left, or upper right. Actually, a lot of the things that I've seen use the webcam on the lower left or lower right, but honestly, it's up to you. There's no right or wrong here. Another really useful panel is the effects panel, right? So this is what I was talking about a little bit earlier. You can choose to select the cursor on recording. Obviously, you want to have that on. And if you want to highlight the cursor with a color like this, in this case, it's blue, so it doesn't really stand out. I mean, it's up to you. You can make it red, and this is really going to stand out a lot. Of course, you can increase the size, make it smaller, that kind of thing. And you can also change the colors of the clicks. You know, a left click is going to be red, a right click is going to be blue. All of this is up to you. And what's super cool about this screen recorder compared to other software available out there is that you can also use the scheduler. So for example, let's assume you do a webinar and you have a million of things to worry about, and sometimes you just forget to hit the record button. It happened plenty of times to me, and I know a lot of people that this has happened to. So in that case, it might be super useful to just schedule a recording and tell it to start at this hour and finish at this hour, and you don't have to worry about a single thing. You can also use this one, set time limit for recording, in case you want to put some sort of upper limit of like, I don't know, 20 minutes or something like that. And you can also tell the software what to do after it's finishing. After it finishes capturing, you can either tell it to go to sleep or to just shut down the computer completely. Alright, that was all for this software. I hope you enjoyed this Movavi screen recorder video guide. If you want to give it a try, make sure to check the free version they have available on their website. And if you want to purchase the full version, make sure you use the discount code available in the description to get 20% off on your purchase. That's all for this video. My name is Eduard Stinga from Videoplasty, and I'll see you very soon.